And now the CNN Trump Town Hall, live from Columbia, South Carolina.
Hello, everyone. Hello, 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 and welcome to South Carolina. We are your hosts tonight. I'm Charles Barkley.
And I am Gayle King. And we're the co-host of a real CNN show that combines our two names, King Charles.
Yeah, I thought it should be Gay Bar. But then I was told that that was terrible.
Yes.
Terrible. Well, it goes without saying, we loved that sketch on Saturday Night Live when we saw it a few weeks ago. Although we did have a few notes on that. Good thing, though, that Charles's alter ego is here. We're very excited that Kenan Thompson is in the house. He's the longest serving SNL cast member ever. The Washington Post, I love this description of you, Kenan, called you a sketch comedy savant.
Oh, nice.
He has been acting since he was a little kid on Nickelodeon's All That and Kenan and Kel, remember that, and the Good Burger movies. And if that isn't enough, he also wrote his first book. Do you mind if we mention the book?
Please.
He also wrote his first book. It's called When I Was Your Age. Welcome to you, Kenan Thompson.
Thank you very much. What a pleasant intro. Thank you.
Well, when it says the longest member standing, 23 years, you were the longest standing member of Saturday Night Live.
21st, wow. But yes. Yeah, it's a long time. I mean, I can't even imagine where all that time went, honestly, because I still feel young, you know?
And you still look young. Yeah. But when you're sitting in front of somebody that you've done an imitation of them, do you get a little nervous? Do you think, I hope they're not angry? You know, clearly he's not. Do you get nervous about that?
Yeah, because we're not out to offend, you know what I mean? We're just having
fun. You're not
out
to offend?
I'm not personally, no. But some people strike you funny. So, you know, you have a very specific tone. Yeah. You know what I mean? And you're a big presence on TV. Everybody
what is his
loves
tone?
You.
Yes.
It's just down in here, you know? It's just a very southern baritonal. I'm a very tall person, so that's how I sound.
First of all, it's a tremendous compliment.
It is.
First and foremost.
Tremendous.
But, like, I've said this. I had a couple of people call me who were hosting Saturday Night Live, and I said, it's the longest damn week of your life.
Yeah, it is.
How do you, like...
Well, you've hosted it.
I have. That's right. And it's the longest week of your life.
Oh, okay.
Gayle, you're rehearsing 10 to 12 hours every single day.
Really?
How do you keep... Like, because you're doing the same thing over and over. How do you keep your energy level and your focus up working that hard every day?
Number one, it's a dream come true. You know what
I
mean?
Oh, wait, there's the two of you together.
Yeah, that was a great one.
That's the prison scene.
Straight. Yeah, that was a great one. Number two, it's different for the host. The host has a lot of responsibility.
Yeah.
Like, we're there more in a supportive role. Third, I work with amazing people, brilliant people in the cast, in front of the camera, behind the camera. You know, it's a several hundred people family, you know what I mean, that are trying to build something new every single week. And yeah, man, you did such a great job that week.
Did he do a good job?
He really did, because I remember when he came in day one, he was like, I've never worked more than 2 hours my whole life.
That's what he said.
I'm not about to start now.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, I don't know about that. Like, you might have, you know, a little different of an experience.
It's amazing.
Because it is fun.
Yeah, it is fun.
Like, it keeps changing. It's sketch comedy, so it's constantly refreshing. So that's how I think 20 years goes by before you even realize, like, what's going on.
Do you ever worry about hurting somebody's feelings when you're doing their impression?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, kind of like any sort of like negative feedback I think that you get from doing, you know, an impression of somebody, I don't think is ideal. Not for me as a performer or any of the performers that I've been around at the show since I've been there. You know, we're just not those kinds of people.
I know, but I think Charles is right. I think you have to be able to laugh at yourself.
You definitely do.
The first time it pops up, though, Kenan, when you see yourself being imitated on Saturday Night Live, you do have that moment of like, oh, God.
Oh, yeah. Is that what they think of me?
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
I hope this is going to go well. But you do have to have a sense of humor. And
you do, and then
it's
also
all in good fun.
The responsibility on our end is to do it with some, you know, a level of respect, you know what I mean? As far as like getting it right is concerned. Like if we're mimicking something and we're just like highly exaggerating, then that's a little egregious, you know what I mean? But a lot of the time it's pretty close to like what's actually kind of happening, and that lets us laugh at it.
That's the thing, especially when it comes to politics. Many people think SNL is dead on when it comes to politics, and they're their take on political figures that are in the news right now.
Some people, and then there's there's other people that are like, shame on y'all, and like, this is sad, and SNL hasn't been funny
since whatever.
It's
sad the way both of these parties, like, just whatever you do to one party, they hate the other party.
But they're equal opportunity offenders, though. You're equal opportunity offenders, I think.
We try to be, you know, like, neutral and just, you know, I say this a lot, but like, really just hold the mirror up to society. Exactly. Like, that's our job, you know?
Yes. You know, you always think about, you've done everybody. Wait, they had some pictures when we were dressed up like women.
Yeah.
Because I've been a woman every time I've been on the show. And it's like, I'll try anything.
Uh-huh. Will you try anything?
I will, because Gayle, when you sit down on Monday.
Yes.
On Monday, you sit with like 30 writers and they just throw ideas at you. Mm-hmm. They have to have them written by Tuesday. Mm-hmm. Then you start really rehearsing on Wednesday. And I always said, I've hosted it 4 times. I'm like, yeah, I dress up like a woman. Uh-huh. I mean, I'm a good-looking woman.
If you do say so yourself.
Yeah, I'm just telling what the public says.
Okay.
But, this is probably the most nerve-wracking thing to me, Gayle.
The monologue?
The monologue.
Uh-huh. Okay.
I mean...
Because it's just you.
The monologue is the hardest part.
Yeah. Yeah. You've done it well. You've done it for... Oh, look at this. Oh, man, we've been buddy-buddies every time we've been on it. I love it. Look, you're so big.
But Kenan, when you started, though, you've been doing this since you were a little kid. Were you imitating a TV show, a CNN-type show?
We used to do, yeah. My brother and I grew up in the cable era, like when HBO first came out. You know what I mean? So that was when we were able to see movies over and over and over again without having to pay for it. You know, and like we would watch Coming to America a million times, Three Amigos a million times, you know what I mean? Like 48 hours, whatever.
Trading we have places. A clip of young Kenan in action. Can you show that, please?
Yeah, we would just, you know, recreate all those scenes. Oh, look at the little baby.
Oh my God. Kenan.
Didn't even go surfing. Look at that. Just wasting everybody's time. That's so funny. What is that? Oh, that's Real News for Kids.
Yes.
Oh, that
Kenan.
Was like my first little. That was a CNN show.
Yes. What were your dreams back then? Did you want to be doing this?
Or something. You know, I was obsessed with the television. I wanted to be, you know, inside of it. Number one, like just to figure out how that worked. But you know, I always enjoyed, you know, the Hollywood or you know the kind of like the mystery of Hollywood or the you know the magic and you know like I don't know the fandom that you get you watch certain shows or whatever. Like, I don't know, I just grew up being a fan of stuff and then wanting to kind of be involved in the industry once I learned that it was an industry, you know, and then trying to figure out what was my service to that industry going to be. And it always kind of was in the performance realm, you know, and
you're
luckily I was trained as
first,
I grew up.
First of all, he has to be great at it because there's no way you can have this extended career unless you're very, very talented because
Thank you.
You seen a lot of them gone.
Yes, mm-hmm. Come
like,
and go.
Yeah. So to start out as a young kid and expand your career, that tells me number one, you're a nice guy.
I appreciate it.
But you're talented. What's next for you? Have you directed anything?
I've directed stuff in the past, but it's not my favorite thing. I like producing a lot, which is why I'm really excited for our company, Artists for Artists. Shout out to Johnny Ryan, he's in the building. Mm-hmm. It's my
Don't
partner
you have a
on
production
it.
Company?
That's it, Artists for Artists, yeah.
Artists for Artists, okay. Mm-hmm.
And, so what kind of stuff you want to produce?
Everything, we helped produce Good Burger 2. That was a big one. That was like one of our first like big, like we're here and we're actually doing stuff kind of moments, basically. And you know, anything under the sun. You know,
you say you didn't like directing.
No, because I can't be asked that many questions. You know what I'm saying? Like it is. Every department is asking you about something. Do you approve of this dress? Do you approve of this look? Do you approve of this table? Do you approve of these lights? Like it's too much for me because I'm like, y'all are supposed to be professionals. Why are you asking me?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But directors have to be meticulous like that. And some people that are great directors are actually very controlling like that and good at it. I'm not very good at it.
So you've been on the show a long time. I mean, obviously, I'm not going to ask you.
23 years.
Not
21.
21.
Yes.
21. Okay.
I'm not going to ask you who's your favorite. Can you give me a short list of the funniest people not in character that you've worked with?
Fred Armisen is one of the greats. Ah. Like, he's one of the great backstage, like, will just keep a bit going, like J.B. Smoove.
Yeah.
J.B. Smoove is a beast. But yeah, there's been a lot of them. I mean, like Jimmy Fallon is high energy, like how he is on TV is how he is in like real life, just high energy, really, really funny. But you know, all of Maya's the greatest, like Amy, Tina, Rachel, really, really, really funny people over the years. Like Sandberg, Bill, like Bill is so reserved and then he turns it up so much when he performs, Bill Hader. You know, it's like night and day from who he is as a person and then when he's performing. It's similar to myself because I'm kind of like mellow.
But do you marvel, Kenan, that you've been on since 2003? You now have two daughters, two young daughters.
I marvel because I can't name them all. You know what I mean? I've had the blessing of working with a whole lot of like really
talented
people. You're
going to say I can't name my daughters.
No, I can't name them daughters. No, I don't know them at all.
Yeah, so for basketball, my daughter got to see me at the end when I was nobody.
Right, right.
You're still doing your thing. Your kids, you said 10, almost 10.
Yeah.
So they've seen you like in your prime.
Yeah.
What do your kids think of you?
They think it's funny because nowadays on SNL, I play a lot of old characters. You know what I mean? So like, anytime they show a clip, they'll see me in like old hair or like gray hair or something, like dressed, you know, in sweaters and glasses. And they're like, why were you such an old person on that thing? And I'm like, you know, I tend to do that a lot because, you know, it's a funny, like, performance zone for me and the audience. Like, the audience likes to see me, you know, when I'm in character and stuff like that.
Do you have a favorite character? Because it was interesting asking people on the street, this one. Is that your favorite character, too?
It was my favorite sketch, yeah. Uh-huh. It, What's Up With That was real strong, you know, and I really loved it because it was personal. Like, I had an idea, and then, like...
Black Jeopardy.
Me and Brian Tucker got to execute.
Jeopardy.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah, Black Jeopardy is incredible. Shout out to Chadwick Boseman. That was the greatest one that we ever did, I think. Besides, like, Tom Hanks' one. Those two are, like, the strongest Black Jeopardies. But, you know, Black Jeopardy had Drake. Black Jeopardy had Elizabeth Banks. You know what I mean? It was a great, great, great sketch.
I mean, if fools walk up to you and say, make me laugh?
Over the years, a lot. And I've let a lot of them down because, like, as you see, I'm like very just, you know, kind of chill. I'm not a joke teller, but I like to laugh and have a good time when, you know, there's a moment that's funny, but, you know, I'm not the joke teller. My dad told me a joke today, you know what I mean? He was like, I got a joke for you.
Is your dad funny?
He's a joke teller. He's really funny.
And now Lauren is approaching 50 years.
Yeah.
You know, there's all sorts of speculation. What will happen? What will happen?
Yeah.
Do you have thoughts about that?
I mean, personally, kind of, but I see how hands-on he is, and it's his baby, you know what I mean? So I can't really imagine.
Yes, I feel that, too.
I don't really know, but, it's his baby,
yes,
you know?
It's his baby, and his baby is doing very well.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Kenan.
You want to hear my dad's joke real quick?
Okay, go ahead.
What was it?
Kenan, you sound like old man.
How far can you run in the woods?
Okay. How far?
Halfway, because then you start running out. I mean, it's more of like a riddle. Like, that's a pretty good joke. Like, that's old school.
You okay?
That's old school. I'm great. Yeah, he thought that was really funny to share at 8 a.m. this morning.
Thank you, Kenan's dad.